person. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little build up right here, and I'm going to put a little bit in his chest and everything, and I'm going to put the detail in later, but I just want to put a little bit of, not too much, because I don't want to get too crazy. Get all like in the joints and stuff. I know this is something everybody does all the time, but... this is just like, I gotta get this, I gotta get a filler. I'm gonna put a little bit on the arms and joints. I'll probably shave that down. Just a little bit right here. Don't mind if it looks all crazy, it's gonna look better, don't worry. These joints. Alright. Okay, we got that. I'm just gonna dab this in here, kind of give it a little texture. Just so it doesn't look like spray foam. Really lightly. This way it gives it like a different kind of look. Alright, it was messy. Alright, now what we're gonna do is make some organs. So I'm just going to make a big blob right here. Okay, then we're going to make another big blob right here. Try to keep it all in one spot. We're just going to keep, you know, just make one big pile. It's okay if they get together. You know, just make a big pile, however you can. Oops, don't get over there. Messy shit. Okay. Now, once you got the big pile, you want to take a squirt bottle and squirt where you just made them big piles at. Okay, now once you do that, then you take some saran wrap, get it all, come here saran wrap, stupid. Okay, put the saran wrap over the top of it. Okay. Alright, get your saran wrap all over all of it first. That way you can do it all at one time. Oh crap, got shit on my hands. Now that you got saran wrap on it, you want to pat it down and smooth it out. Just keep patting it down. That's gonna hurt. Yeah, just cut, you know, keep, try to keep your shape. Try to blend it all together so it dries nice and smooth. Try not to get it on your hands. Keep patting it down until it's, you know, you almost got a smooth surface of what, where you were just. Alright. Alright, so now you wanna, I just wanna just kinda put this little, so I can separate these two a little bit and separate this one a little bit. Stuff back in there. Oh. Yeah, just like that. There. Okay, that's that for now. Then we'll go a little further and I'll show you more. Okay, so what I did was I let it dry and the plastic, I took the plastic off. Plastic came off real easy. If I was to do this again, I wouldn't put as much, you know, as a buildup. I would have made it like smaller, little. It's supposed to look like kidneys, lungs, stuff like that. I would have made it, or just a blob of stuff that just, you know, fell from his chest cavity. So if I was to do it again, I'd make him a little bit smaller. But then that's why we do how to. So you can do it however you want. So right now I'm just going to put like little bits of spots right here. I'm going to put another little blob right there. Just do spots. I'm just going to do like little spots. Of course this thing's coming out like a crazy man. So I'll go a little slower, do like spots like that. Little spots here and there, whatever. Keep doing that. Okay, let's see if I can shut this thing. Oh, shut. Okay, it's not gonna shut. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna spray it again. Because I don't want it to look like spray foam. And what I'll do, is put the plastic on it. And then what I'll do is I'll shape it into a ball. There. This way you can play with it a little bit. I And once it starts to dry a little bit, you can shape it a little more. You know, shape it in like little balls. And this way, it won't expand real big, but it will expand, but not as big. I just want like little. See if I can do this without getting spray foam all over my hand this time. Oh, damn it. Nope. Not gonna happen. Shit. Well, it's hard to put plastic on when you got spray foam all over your hands. Okay. Now that I got that on, I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit, let it expand. Was that? No. Let it expand a little bit, and then I'm gonna kind of like shape it a little bit, you know, with my hands, make it look more smoother, so it doesn't look like spray foam. And then, because as it starts expanding, you can move it around and kind of shape it. So, okay. That should be good for now, and then I'll show you what it looks like at the end. I mean, when it's all done. Okay, so I took the plastic off, and it's got, you know, some nice little round blobby bumps or partial intestines, whatever you want it to be. Now I'm gonna use latex and latex the whole body a certain way, and we'll see how that goes. We'll see what it looks like. Okay, what I did right here is I had some latex and a brush, and I brushed all this on the back of these pans. And what's gonna happen is when this dries, I'm gonna be able to pull it up for skin, and the skin is going to go on the skeleton, and you can pretty much make latex do anything you want. You know, make it look like stretched skin, broken, peeled, whatever. So that's where I'm at right now. Okay, and what I did here was, while that was drying, I brushed latex all over the ribs. And then once that dry, latex always sticks to itself really good. So I pulled it off in a sheet and laid it onto the ribs, and then I poked holes in it here. Now the cool thing about latex is that you can just take your finger and go like this, and it'll make little veins and creases and stuff. You know, you ain't even gotta put no pressure on it. Just go like this, and it makes a nice texture. And then I poke some holes in it. And I'm going to do this with the whole body and the arms. I didn't take me doing this because I wasn't sure if it was gonna work, and I didn't wanna waste your time. So, but seeing that it went on there real nice and it looks cool, then I'm gonna do the rest with it. The rest of them, I'll show you how I did it. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to latex the whole body from head to toe, even the head, and then I'm going to dry sheets of latex and cover the whole thing. And then what I'll do is make little pieces of latex to string across, because it's going to be easy, because all this latex likes to stick to itself, so it's better than having to the light door. It's better than having to use plastic, I think. I'm not sure. I'll let you know. Well, you'll see when it's done if it's better than using plastic. Plastic's much more cheaper, but if you got a bucket of latex, you can use it for masks, you use it for props, you can pretty much use it for everything. So that's where we're at right now. Okay. First one dried, now I'm going to stick it right here. Oh shoot, Well, you gotta be careful where you stick it because it's gonna stick. There we go. So you just like move it around like this and break it up a little bit, make it look like strings. You know, this kind of takes you away from having to do the cotton thing. You know what I'm saying? You get the nice strings like this. And then you can just go like this, make all kinds of little creases and holes. And see how gnarly this looks? Let me see if I can get a close up on it. Looks pretty gnarly. Let's see if I can get a close up on it. I'm using my camera, so because I can use two hands. Looks pretty good. You know, and I'll just keep doing this throughout the whole body and just get it real nasty, and should look pretty good. And if you got a dirty pan like I had, it gives it extra color. Okay, I just got another piece off. This is what it looks like. I'm gonna stick it right on his head. And move it. And one thing I notice is like if you let after you coated it with latex and you let it sit too long, you might have to go hit it with latex again just so it's still sticky. So I'll be doing that from now on. Just, and what I'm doing, let me take this roll. What I'm gonna do is like just bunch it up like this and see how it, I don't know if you can see that or not, but bunch it up, pinch it, and it gets all, it makes it look like the vines and all the skin and stuff. And I got it on the head right here, and then you just go like this, and it looks like skin peeling. Just rub it. Looks really good. And you probably can't see it from the camera, but let me see what we're looking at. Yeah, we can see it. Can't really see it, but I'll take a picture or two of what it looks like up close. Yeah, it really sticks on there too. So yeah, see how you can like cut like flesh holes out. Yeah, it looks really good. See, and then you got this, you got these stuff here coming across. But like I said, like if you let it sit too long, like I don't know, you might want to hit this with latex again, just so when you put your next skin on, it has a nice, like really sticks really good. It's looking good. I'm gonna do some more here, do some neck, some more skin neck part here. I gotta do the rest of this, and I'll do the arms and keep working at it. Looks really good. I think I like this technique. I mean, obviously it's a little more expensive because it's latex, but I think it gives a lot more. I mean, it's not as hard as the, I don't know how hard the cotton is, but this is pretty much does whatever you want it to do. Like if you were to do the cotton thing, cotton and latex. All right, I don't know if you want me to show you how I do the whole thing like this, but I'll do it anyways, just so you know. All right, so I'm gonna put some more on it. Got this little sheet of latex. I'll keep on doing it until I get it right, I guess. So, I guess I'll just flop it on. I'll just keep, rubbing it like this. I get the creases, get the skin fleshy stuff. Any holes you can just. Oh yeah, that's looking good. And I'll just keep doing this until I get it all done. Looks good. Let me see if I can get a close up on it. All right, I put this piece on. My camera keeps shutting off, but I put it on there and I just kind of went like this and put holes in it. I'm gonna just keep working at it. Keep putting layers on and see where it goes. Apparently my camera don't want to work, so I put some more plastic on there, some around the chest, put an extra layer here. It's turned out okay. Like I said before, I think I went a little too overboard with this. Next time I do it, I'll tone it down a little bit and not make it as big, but it still looks cool. So that's where I'm at so far. I'll just keep putting layers of latex on and then see what happens. Okay, and what I do here is I take a brush of latex and just brush on these little squares like this. And I peel them off, stretch them off, and I put them on the body. Makes little veiny looking stuff. Now I have these two trays of latex for skin. And I'll probably cut these into squares and do the same thing. I wasn't gonna use it for skin, but I had enough, so that's where we're at. Okay, and here's what them little squares do. I take two hands, I stretch it out as far as I can, and then I lay it on there and let go, and it kind of curls up and makes these little stringy, nasty little balls and stuff. Makes it look like veins and everything, like this here. You know, so I just stretch it out with two hands as far as I can and then let it go and land on here. And then I roll it and it does make it look like a gross little thing. I mean, and I just keep putting latex on. I take the little squares for all the detail and stuff to make the strings go across and all that. And just keep putting them little latex, little stringy crap on there. I didn't videotape the whole thing because I can't do it and hold the camera. I don't have a camera stand. My 35 millimeter camera, for some reason, it won't take videos after 2 seconds. It stops. So that's where I'm at so far. It's turning out pretty good. Hopefully I'm going to do a little bit more here and then I'll be ready to paint. People, I went over this with golden pecan wood stain. So we're gonna see how many washes I can put on this to make it look right. I'm not really sure what I'm doing, but I think it's a good base coat, kind of fleshy color. Maybe I might go over it a couple times, we'll see. Okay, so I put on some airbrush pure paint and I watered it down and then I dabbed it with a towel to get most of it off, just to leave a little bit. I'll just keep putting coats on it until I get the color I want, I guess. Okay. Okay, I took a little sapphire blue and did the guts here, and then threw the brush at the chest just to give it spots, and you know, just to give it some type of depth or whatever. And then I'll go over with a couple other coats and see what I come up with. At the end, I'll probably just do like a big wash to blend it all in. Let's see how it goes. Okay, right now I'm just dry brushing like a lime green on the skin here. Just giving it just another layer of color. Not putting a lot on, I'm just dabbing it, and I'll keep adding more. But I'm gonna go through and get all the hanging skin. Try to highlight up in here, you know, get a little bit up in there. The spots on the skin look pretty good where I flicked the blue on there. It looks pretty good. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'll let you know when I do the next color. Okay, I'm using this splatter matter flexible prop glaze from Asylum Props. I usually use other stuff, but this was like the right size. I didn't want to do it. And what I'm doing is I'm getting inside the chest there, and I'm going all around the guts, and I'm just kind of like making it look gross before I put my black wash on it. It should probably make everything. I'm hoping the wash is going to make everything pop out. If not, I'll restart the whole thing over with all new colors. Okay, that's where I'm at right now. And what I'm doing, I'm just taking it with the brush and just patting around in there, you know, around the wounds and stuff like that. Okay, that's it for now. Okay, well, I got all the blood and stuff in. Now I'm gonna try to find a stain or something that I can go over the whole thing. Then I'll probably go back over it with some more blood and see. And we'll see. It's the first time doing it like this. I don't know what I'm doing. Alright. Okay, I went over it with golden oak twice. I think it looks pretty gory. Pretty nasty. I'm going to go over it a couple more times. With a darker, but I think it looks pretty good. Get a little darker, a little nastier, a darker blood in here probably. You can see like the bone exposed. Looks okay. Gotta get a little darker inside there. Okay, so now, after I got it all done, I'm going back with a little teeny bit of saddle tan, and like hitting these little spots right here, just to make it look nice and gross. I'm not going to go over the whole thing. I'm just going to do little spots, you know, to make it look gross. And, I'm just going to dab around, you know, and like all around, like the wounds and stuff. I'm just going to go like that and dab around them. So it looks real nice and nasty, just to give it like a darker tone. And I'm going to go through the whole thing, and I'm thinking that it'll be done after that. I'll give you a shot of it after I'm done going through it. I don't want to sit there and have you watch me pat around through it. But I just dab it in there and put it in all the cracks and the nasty stuff. So that's where I'm at. Okay, so I'm still doing with the tan stuff, the leather tan. And I'm just hitting like these little spots right here real gently. I mean, I didn't tape the whole thing, but because it's kind of monotonous, you know. So I'm just going to, you know, just do the little creases like this. And, you know, make it look real nasty without darkening the whole thing up. I just want to hit, like, some of the creases and stuff. And, yeah, I think it looks real gross. think it looks really good. I didn't darken it up. I just highlighted. Oh crap! Put too much on that. There we go. I just highlighted some of the nastiness. You know, because I still wanted to keep all the colors and spots and washes that I put on there. So I just, you know, I just wanted the nastiness to stand out a little more. So I think I pretty much got it. Yeah, I didn't tape the whole thing because, you know, you've watched people do this stuff before. And if I do a little too much, I'll dab it and get it all fixed. But I think it looks pretty gnarly, all fleshy. And let me put this on a how-to in a video, and then you guys can do it yourself. All right, thanks guys for watching.
Listen.